All right. God damn it. I'm editing the part one of the Bitcoin, bro. This is a problem with daily vlogging. It's like you don't even know. You start off with one concept and you end up with another. I don't even know if the Bitcoin thing is even a thing. I took Friday night off. I didn't mean to. I just was too tired. It was my birthday. We had a cake cutting and all this stuff. And by the time I got home, I just kind of got in bed, relaxed, and I thought, well, there's a Miami Heat playoff game, so it's usually dead because everybody's watching the Heat game, even if it's not in Miami. So I'll do a late night. And then I just kind of woke up like at fucking 12:30 at night, and I was like, you know what? I'm just going back to bed. I'm going to hit the morning. But I checked the group chat. They said it was slow. Shit didn't pick up till like 4 in the morning, which was only a couple hours ago. It's 6:45 right now, a.m. I am completely rested, which is good, because Saturday, I've been meaning to do a Saturday all fucking day. Let's fucking run it. How much money can we make on Uber on a Saturday in Miami? This Bitcoin convention is a big bust, man. I didn't get anything. I haven't edited part two, but you'll see part two. I drove down the beach. I didn't get shit. So I was like, either they don't know where to go, or they're in their hotel rooms fucking checking their little Bitcoin apps. I don't know what the fuck they're doing, but they're not spending money. They said Wynwood was busy last night, but like, whatever. Let's see. Today is their real big going away after party. It's in Wynwood. So I hope they didn't fucking piss their whole fucking load yet. Anyways, I'm gonna shower and brush my teeth and get ready. This is exporting, and let's run this Saturday. I don't even know what I'm gonna call this video.
Boy, if I got up this early every day, I could take advantage of 12 cent supercharging. Then again, usually by this time on a weekday, I'm tired as hell from coming back from airport reservations. And you don't want to spend like 40 minutes charging your car to 100. But, see, it's 7:40. I'm going to go to the Dadeland Station charger. Even though it's a slower charge, I can get there before 8. And it's 12 cents a kilowatt. So, let's go there.
Flashing yellow lights at fucking 7:40 in the morning. Like, you know. This is the other thing, is the traffic to get here on a weekday would be bonkers right now.
I don't know if I mentioned it, but when I got my bill for the charging of the month, last month, let's see, I was at 17,000 miles and some change. And I turned it in at 23,000 miles. So I went 6,000 miles in 1 month driving this car around. Driving to the airport, driving to Fort Lauderdale, driving to fucking Homestead, driving to Miami Beach, driving back, driving fucking everywhere. Driving Uber X, driving Uber Premier, driving this car everywhere. The amount of transportation I provided in 1 month was 6,000 miles. How much did I pay to charge this car in 6,000 miles? I just want to keep repeating that. 6,000 miles people do in 6 months of driving regularly. An Uber driver drives 6,000 miles, can drive 6,000 miles in 1 month. How much gas did I spend? Let's put it that way. How much gas money would 6,000 miles cost you? cost me $271.71. That is insane. The amount of propulsion that this vehicle took, and at speeds that were greater than any car I've ever been in. I go on the expressway, boy, it's easy to hit fucking 85, 90 miles per hour, and you don't even know it. Express lanes. That's insane. It's 7:55 a.m. I'm at 50%. It's charging at 12 cents. Now, this is a 72 kilowatt charging station. I could have gone to the one in Kendall. But if I don't get there before 8 a.m., it goes up. Every supercharger goes up in price after 8 a.m. So, better to charge slow here at 12 cents than risk getting there at 8:01, and then how much would it be? Okay, you know what? Kendall's not that bad. It changes from 12 to 13. I didn't notice that. So, man, Kendall's the place to be if you wake up late, because you got until 12 for that 13 cent charge. That's good to know. That means I don't have to, if I get home really tired, I can get rest, head out at least at 11, make it to Kendall by 11:30, charge. That's going to be one of my new plans if I'm going to work the afternoon shift. Start in Kendall. Dude, last night, I mean yesterday, Friday, today's Saturday, Friday, I worked Homestead. I got a ride to Florida City, and I said, all right, fuck it, let's go to Florida City. I was in Kendall. I got a ride to Florida City, and I said, fuck it, let's try to work our way up. And I worked up against traffic, and I made it up here. I got an airport ride in Kendall, or Cutler Bay. So I went to the airport. I left Premier only on. Got a Premier. I made $100. I didn't work yesterday. I made $136 in the afternoon shift. Then, you know, I had to go to my family's house. They did a little cake cutting for me and all that. And by the time I got home, I was just too damn tired. And I'm catching up on the group chat, and it didn't seem like this Bitcoin conference made a difference. I mean, it was just like a regular ass night in Miami Beach and Wynwood. Some of them broke 300. Great. Great. But, and it didn't start until like 4 o'clock in the morning. Like, dude, in Miami on a weekend, it's not impossible that at 4:30 to 5, you're still picking up club goers, not just airport rides. So I think this is a good idea to start super early on Saturday. Let's see what comes in. We got the cruise ports. Man, that car, you know, somebody rented the Virgin Cruise Lines for 4 days. I don't know if it has anything to do with these Bitcoin bros. I doubt it, but some millionaire rented a Carnival cruise, not Carnival, Virgin Atlantic cruise for 4 days. Took off yesterday at night. But you know what? I don't mind. I know yesterday was my birthday, so it's just if any night, I don't even like working Friday nights late as it is. So even less on my birthday, right? I don't know. I was like, yeah, I probably could have made an extra $100. But whatever. Look what happened to somebody at the group chat. Huh? That could have been me.
So, you know, Fridays, I don't like them. I don't like them. So I'm starting to do well Fridays in the... I mean, if it wasn't my birthday and I didn't have to go to, like, this cake cutting thing, I could have kept going and ended my night relatively early. Just take advantage of the people going out on Friday nights. You don't want to pick them up when they're coming back home. That's the shit show. You know, after 12, after 1 in the morning, that's the shit show. And then you miss out on the weekend mornings where people need to go to the cruises, people need to go to the airport. You know, it's just not worth it. And it's unbelievable. I've been Ubering now for 4 months, and I'm still, well, almost five. I'm still developing my strategy, and it's ever-changing. But those are some of the staples. Sometimes there's exceptions, right? Big events are exceptions. Now, I thought this Bitcoin thing was going to be a big event, but talking to the group chat, it doesn't seem like it made a dent. It's just like an average Miami Beach thing. I mean, you know, it's like Bitcoin. They think they're big in their own world, but as far as the rest of the world's concerned, it's like, what? Whatever.
All right, it's 8:25. I'm at 97%.
I think I'm... You know, I got 3 minutes left remaining. I'm already signed in. I signed in to Premiere just in case one would pop up. There's a boat show going on in Key Biscayne, too. I think that's more promising for me than this Bitcoin thing going on. But whatever. We're just going to cruise around. I'm going to have nothing but Premiere and Comfort Electric on. Just to feel it out. Just to see if anything comes in. Nothing comes in, I'll turn everything on. You know, I had a lot of luck yesterday morning with everything on. I did greens, Uber X's, comforts came in. The ride to the airport was a comfort, and then I got a Premiere out of that. So, I need to, you know, all these events that happen in Miami, you get so used to Premiere ringing all the time. And you gotta remind yourself that that's not normal. That's not, you know, you can make good money on this thing just doing Uber X and comfort rides. But you have to kind of let go of the idea that, hey, I just want to do the cream of the crop orders. Like, hey man, yesterday I did all right because I kept busy, you know? It's also kind of more fun having some Uber X clients in the car, too. It's like you talk to them. They're normal people. You don't feel like, oh, this is a Premier client. I have to be like on my P's and Q's. All right, let's get out of here. All right. What do people do on Saturdays? Do they go to the mall? By Dadeland. Wouldn't hurt to swing around Dadeland. You know, one time, this is back when I had the Kia, I got a great ride, obviously it was an Uber X, from Dadeland to like Sunny Isles. Paid quite a bit, forgot the details, but I remember that being like a great ride, and especially if they tip, you know? All right, nothing came in Premier Comfort Electric, clearly. So I turned everything on, and I got a Uber X ride into the Grove from basically Sunset Place nearby where I live. So let's handle this, and maybe this will position us in a better place. All right. Boy, you never know where you end up when you accept a ride on Uber. We're at the historic Vizcaya Gardens. Village and Gardens. It's like an old school mansion here. I haven't been here in years. Actually, don't even remember how to... Oh, so there's parking there. There's a whole little rideshare thing. I think the last time I was here, Uber didn't even exist.
That's how long ago. I went and I did a party here. I celebrated a New Year's here once. One of the first years I worked for the Miami Herald. I had VIP tickets. You know, when you're in the Miami Herald back in the day, you worked for the Miami Herald before the internet took over media. And it was like, you know, you got invited to these exclusive events. People would like have tickets to things, press passes, and they would like leave them on the newsroom. Hey, you want to go to Vizcaya this New Year's? I can't go. Here you go. And I remember it was a fun time. It's like hidden deep here within, between Key Biscayne and Coconut Grove. So that was actually a great positioning ride, because even though it was only $7.32, I doubt the chick's gonna tip. Maybe she will, who knows. We can make a turn and go to Key Biscayne, but I ain't doing that just yet. I'm gonna head straight into Brickell area and downtown Miami. Alright. Got a Comfort Electric here at the Marriott Marquis to the airport. Comfort Electric Premier, that's all I got on. So let's do it. Alright, I'm here in downtown just to get to this fucking Marriott Marquis is the biggest pain in the ass. And now we got the bridge. You know, the bridge is up, so it's like, and the customer's like texting me, how long is it gonna take? I'm like, bro, don't even. I'm like, I'm 1 minute away, 2 blocks away, red lights, etc. He's this close. He doesn't even know. Like, he thinks I'm 2 minutes away, but he's this close to fucking realizing he's 15 minutes fucking away for the next goddamn Uber driver if I cancel on his ass. I'm starting to get very little patience for people trying to hurry you up. I'm like, bitch, do you know how to drive in fucking downtown Miami? Fucking one-way streets everywhere. You gotta turn around and fucking stuck in traffic, bridges, fucking I-95 exits that are fucking one fucking lane. You know? Look at this fucking exit. All right. We are at the airport Delta. Easy ride. I shouldn't lose my patience. He was a nice man. Indian guy. Going to Atlanta. Worked in tech. You know, friendly conversation. He wasn't upset or anything. It's just when you're driving and you have to, like, communicate, text with people, it gets frustrated. Anyways. So we're leaving the Miami International Airport, and now I have Premier on only, as I do always. See if I get a little Premier ride out of the airport. Come on, brah. Come on, brah. Yesterday it happened like clockwork. And the day before that it happened like clockwork. And I took that guy to the Ritz-Carlton Coconut Grove. No, it says head to waiting lot. Let's see what the waiting lot's like. The waiting lot says, you're gonna get a ticket, buddy. Medium. All these people making U-turns here. Cops, the group chat is all up on it. You know what? Good. I'm glad they're giving tickets here. I don't ever make illegal U-turns there. Alright. It says medium weight. It says Comfort Electric has the least amount of cars, so I might hop out of here with another Comfort Electric. Let's see what happens. So, Premier 26 to 30, Comfort Electric 1 to 5. I need to focus on this app that the group chat. I need to ask about what it is that has all the flights coming in. Because that part two of Thursday's video, where I ended it at the airport waiting lot, I didn't get shit. I turned everything on, X everything. It was empty in there. I don't get anything here in 5 minutes, I'm going to the beach, man. I would love to get a ride from the airport going to the beach, because that's where I'm headed.
All right, I gave it 5 minutes. I'm out of here, dude. I don't have patience for this fucking airport thing again, bro. This is... Don't do it. Fuck this. Sitting here waiting for an average ride that, you know, you get outside. Anyways, I need to go to the T-Mobile. I have some errands to fucking do, too. I gotta go to the T-Mobile store. Sprint. I feel like I always talk about this. When I set up my T-Mobile hotspot thing at the house. Sprint merged with T-Mobile. Now, I was told not to do anything because eventually it would all just merge and I could sign in to my T-Mobile account using my existing. The problem is the email that I'm using for Sprint is my email, and some fucker on T-Mobile who isn't me has a T-Mobile account before Sprint even merged with T-Mobile. And he's been using my email. I get notifications when the guy makes a payment, when the guy's payment is due. His name is Manuel Mateo, right? I'm Mario Mateo, okay? So I get this guy's fucking junk mail from T-Mobile, and I've tried calling before. I'm like, hey man, this guy, damn it. I can go on a fucking hour-long rant about this. I tried calling one time and going like, and this was maybe has happened to many people with different services. You go, hey man, somebody else's account is using my email. And then they go, okay, well, can we verify your email? I'm like, your phone number? Okay, fine. Boom, verified my phone number. It's me. Now, can you change the email? Oh no, because we need to email that guy to tell him that he's got the wrong email. Oh yeah, but when you email that guy, you're emailing me, dipshit. You're not emailing the guy that put the wrong email in. So it's like an endless fucking circle, and you can never get this done. This is one of those things that you have to go in and talk to somebody at the thing and have them manually call a supervisor or something. Like, because let's suppose they go, okay, now, well, we need to contact the guy who put your email to change it. Well, how long is that going to take? How do you... that guy clearly is not checking his email for T-Mobile accounts, and who knows what if he doesn't check his phone for alerts? So, like, and what if, like, he'll get to it, because it's not a priority on his side. He doesn't give a shit. He's paying his bill online every week, every month. You know what? Fuck this. I'm not even gonna get into this. I'm just gonna get upset. The bottom line is I need to go to the T-Mobile store and fix fucking problems. All right, I'm at the most ghetto T-Mobile store off 8th Street and 57th Avenue. Let's see if someone here can help me. All right. I shouldn't have gotten that upset. They couldn't change it manually at the store, but, you know, these people were nice, and they put a note on my account, so the next time I call T-Mobile support, they'll be able to update my email with T-Mobile. And hopefully the guy who's using my email will vanish. I told him, it's like, this has got to happen. This has got to be a more common problem. Because, I mean, how many times do people mistakenly type out emails or forget a letter or something, and then it goes to a real email user who happens to use that service, like Netflix or fucking, you know, Hulu or fucking their fucking FPL bill, their fucking water bill, whatever. Anybody can mistype an email, and then that's a real email somebody's getting. All right, let's just continue this, man. This is like a headache. So basically, I just have to call support, and then
they're going to change it. So I have to do that later on today. I don't even think about it right now. So let's log back in. I almost got derailed there.
All right. Another Comfort Electric going to the airport. But this one's a lot near because I'm in Coral Gables right now.
So should be like an 8 minute. I'm right next to the airport. So it should be like an 8 minute trip.
So that's it. That Comfort Electric's hitting, bro. That's awesome.
All right. That Comfort Electric done. Now that was an interesting conversation I had with that nice man. As I said, I was in the Gables. When I picked him up, the address was all fucked up. It said near and then the address. And the man informed me, first of all, this guy was very well informed. I enjoy when I learn things about the city and the Uber services through the customer. He lived on a street that one side of the street was considered Gables, Coral Gables, and the side of the street he was on is unincorporated Miami. But I didn't know that it was in the middle of a random street. And he was telling me about how the taxes, and they're trying to incorporate them, but the taxes are too high for Gables, and on his side of the street is near the 8th Street side, so there's still like hourly rate motels, and Coral Gables ordinances don't allow for hourly rate motels to cut off on prostitution, all these things. And there's a trailer park on 8th Street that's in that unincorporated area. And it's like, when you think of Coral Gables, you don't think about trailer parks. Anyways, the guy ordered Comfort Electric, and he asked me, hey man, is there a reason why Uber is so cheap lately? And I said, really? Well, you ordered Comfort Electric. You shouldn't have been that cheap. And he goes like, oh man, no, this was like fucking, it was like $9 or something. And I'm like, oh, well, you live close to the airport. And he's like, no, but we've paid like $34 for this same exact ride. And even on X. And I'm like, really? And I had to be like a weird fucking time. He said he usually goes above Uber X, because on a business trip, which is what I've speculated about Uber Premier, on a business trip, anything above X gives you Marriott points for his Marriott card or whatever. Business card. And I'm like, oh, that's interesting. I go, so who sets that up? Marriott or Uber? Because if you think about it, the other Comfort Electric I had from the Marriott Marquis in Brickell, that was a Comfort Electric here too. So maybe that guy has Marriott points. So they're creating an incentive for them not to choose X, to choose Comfort or Comfort Electric. He says he chooses Comfort Electric because, well, he's a smart man and he realized he's going to get a Tesla all the time. He also told me in Canada, some Ubers are over there have Polestars. That's the electric vehicle by the same company that makes Volvos. And he says, and I go, really? That's nice. And he goes, you know what? I prefer the Tesla. And he goes, hey, that's good to know too. I guess Tesla is above Polestar. All right. Well, that was an interesting, informative ride, and I'm glad I accepted it. And now let's try to get out of the fucking airport.
All right, leaving the airport, I think just gonna stop fucking around and
take the 112 to the 195 and head to Miami Beach, bro. We just gotta get to the beach, bro, because I'm gonna get stuck here doing shitty rides and never, you know, just like the other day, never get to the beach.
All right, it's a beautiful day here in Miami Beach, so roll down the windows, turn the air off. Just soaking in the sights and sounds.
I feel like I always film this corner. Whenever I decide to film, it's always this corner. 17th and Collins. With these two stores. One of them's Wings and the other one's Alvin's. They just sell beach stuff. I kind of like that Hawaiian shirt. But you see, this is where this whole thing makes more sense than a, you know, a button up and a suit jacket. You know, you don't want to look like a chauffeur here. I mean, there's a fucking yellow Lamborghini in front of me, right? Everyone's dressed casually. You know, and this is the kind of atmosphere where I want to turn X and comfort and green on. Because I want people to come in this car. I just want anybody in here. I want to talk to somebody. These people are all having a good time. They're in a good mood. I want to be a part of whatever's going on here. This beautiful place. Boom, and just like that, with everything on, I got a premiere ride staying in the beach, $10, short distance. Let's get it.
All right, well, you won't believe this, but it seems I'm still the Pura Vida guy.
That guy wanted to go to Pura Vida with his daughter, a foreign guy, I think they were Indian. And the one is on 19th and something. I was almost there. And then he's like, oh, I think there's a different location. Do you mind taking me to the different location? And I said, sure. Where is it? It's the one here on West and 10th Street where the supercharger is that I go to. But I'm at 79, so I don't need to charge. So, hey, man, from DoorDash to Uber, still going to Pura Vida like a madman.
It also goes to show that putting everything on doesn't mean you're only going to get Uber X.
I feel like Uber and DoorDash, well, it started with DoorDash, but DoorDash is the only experience that I have with gig apps besides Uber, where DoorDash knew the high tipping orders, the priority, I even forgot what the fuck they called them, the little green diamond ones. They would hide those because they knew you were cherry picking for them. So they would hide them, they would give you an order for the restaurant that good order was at, but they would give you a shitty order for that restaurant. And until you accepted that shitty order, then a minute later they would throw you the good one as an add-on. Like, hey, you were a good boy, you played ball. You were doing the shitty no-tip order, and now we threw you the priority order right after you accept it. See, they're trying to fucking hide. They're trying to limit it, weed out the cherry pickers. And I wouldn't be surprised if Uber's doing the same thing with Premieres, especially since we all got Teslas around here. You run around with only Premiere on, you know, guess what? They'll give that Premiere that you're hunting for to the guy that has UberX and Comfort Electric on, as well as Premiere, to be like, yo, you gotta play ball. It's the same little tactic, bro. Same gig economy tactic, where, you know, you gotta do one for them, and then they'll toss you a bone. And on the group chat, they're also talking about how, you know, I think they're capping us because everybody's making around $200 a day. You know, a little bit more, a little bit less, but generally around there. And you know, if they throw you a bunch of great premieres, all of a sudden you see like, holy shit, nothing's coming in. I was like, yeah, nothing's coming in because you're waiting for more premieres. And I think the converse is true because I feel like when I bite the bullet and do a few Uber X rides, later on in the day they toss me a few premieres. So who knows how this works, man? This algorithm is not set out. Trust me, if they could toss me 5 premieres in a row worth $50 each, and I'll be done by fucking 2:30 and call it a fucking day. But they don't want that. They want my little ant-like fucking Tesla circling around this fucking county available to fucking give people rides. They're not making any money if I fucking tap out early and go home and call it a day. They need me on the street, bro. They're gonna cap me to keep me going. I mean, we have no way of proving this, but A lot of people on the group chat seem to agree with that idea that, you know, they just give you enough to keep going. That's why I like to log off sometimes and log back in like an hour later.
You know, to mess with the algorithm.
I got everything on and nothing's coming in. All right, you know what? We're on Washington and 17th Street, right by Lincoln Road. But what else is right next to us is the Miami Beach Convention Center, where all the crypto nerds are. Come on, crypto nerds, did you blow your fucking wad last night? Did you guys all blow your fucking wad last night? Throw me some fucking premiere rides, crypto bros. Come on, man, you're ballin'. You got the fucking crypto. You got the Ethereum. Look at this. Uber green to the airport departures. Fuck it, let's do it. Asme, Miami Beach. Oh yeah, I've heard of this. That's where I dropped off those hot UM chicks the other day. It's like a rooftop bar, but it's on Espanol. It's kind of like a hot new spot. Asme. Those UM girls were beautiful. And they were talking about hooking up with like foreign dudes with money. Just weird shit. But here it is. Here it is. Here's my Bitcoin 2023 experience. Okay, there you go. It's over. That was the convention center. Thanks a lot, fuckwads. I gave more rides when I wasn't vlogging the day before this conference started, when they all got here. It's like, they just needed rides to their hotels. After that, I haven't seen a fucking Bitcoin ride to save my life. This might be too early. Today's their big blowout in Wynwood, so let's calm down. All right, let's head to the airport.
All right, we are at American Airlines.
We're about to complete this. I almost forgot to turn off everything. Now I'm completing the ride.
Great rider, she was cool.
Just a cool little couple from Pennsylvania. Very nice people. Asking me about Fort Lauderdale. Because they saw Miami Beach as a little bit too touristy. Although, where they were staying is a nice little... That Asme place has a rooftop bar, but it's a boutique hotel. And it's interesting. It's like really nice people come out of there. It might be a new hotspot nobody knows about yet. All right, I got Premier on only in the airport. Can you imagine if I fucking completed the ride and they threw me an X out of here?
Miami International Airport. The hub of Central America. And the Caribbean, really.
All right, it says head to waiting lot, but fuck that. Say hi to Errata. Emrata. I'm out of here, bro. I'm going right back to the beach, bro. This is Causeway to Causeway. Take the causeway to south to North Beach. You go down. Fuck it. That's actually not bad, bro. Just keep Premier and Comfort Electric on. And just do airport rides all day. That's fine. All good. High tip potential. And no traffic and... pretty easy to come in and out.
Alright, I kind of went a little north to Miami Beach. Here's the Eden Rock and the Fountain Blue.
Just Premier Comfort Electric. If I get desperate, I'll turn on Comfort and Green. But if Electric's hitting, bro, I want to give Electric a chance to hit.
I use this building as an example when I talk to tourists. You see how this, the skeleton of the old facade is still visible on this hotel? And it's like being constructed on the inside. They have to do it like that because of the Preservation Society. See how it is?
Like, it would be so much easier to just demolish that and rebuild it. But they have to keep the facade exactly because it's the historic Art Deco design from the 20s and stuff. And the historical society here, they have to treat it as a historical monument. So they can build additions to it, which they clearly are, but the front of that building has to stay the same. Even down to the color of the paint. Like, if that, if in historical record, that building was yellow, that pastel yellow, it has to stay pastel yellow, I believe. I don't know if they eased up on the painting restrictions, but that's what I've heard through the grapevine here, people that I know in South Florida that deal with that kind of shit. I'm filming this for posterity because I'm pretty sure the last time I passed by here, that Lamborghini was yellow. Am I crazy? Did somebody pass by here and swap Lamborghinis? I'm gonna go down Ocean Drive for a change. You know what I've noticed? That, the street's blocked here. That, Ocean Drive, for some reason, right where that Mango's Cafe is, I guess so many tourists, people that are here for work, get funneled through that street. You know, people who don't know any better, like, just like that Ocean Drive on Miami Beach. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's nice, and it is got that vibe. It's the first street, it has the ocean breeze. There's definitely people watching to be done there. But it's super touristy, like the shops and all the thing, you know, it's like, you can imagine. But for some reason, I always pick up rides on Ocean Drive. Why? Because I think people are here for work or conferences, they get funneled in here, and then they're like, all right, we've had enough. Let's get the fuck out of here. And I've picked up some Premier rides from this street. Premier, Comfort Electric, because like they're here and they're like, all right, we've seen enough of South Beach. Let's get back to our hotel. And they order an Uber. So it's always nice to check it out. Let's check it out. Let's check out Ocean Drive. Maybe we'll catch the Versace Mansion. Beautiful. You see how this is like a yellow building? I'm pretty sure they can't change that color. All these color schemes have to stay the same. It's only in certain areas, though. I think when you get to North Beach or Bay Harbor Islands, the historical society changes. White Lambo. Pink Taco. And to our left is the beach. I haven't been in the salt water in a long time, man. I really need to hit the beach one of these days. Maybe I'll vlog it. I've gained 15 pounds. Don't have much of a beach bod. Not like I ever did, but at least I was skinny. Here's the Versace Mansion. Everybody pulling up to it. That's called the Villa. I think it's like a restaurant or something now. Or a boutique hotel. I'm not sure. Check this out. God, I'm gonna get a mishap. I don't think those things are meant for climbing. This is the area I pick up people. This is like the tourist section. There's that place, and then there's Mango's and the Clevelander up here. There's the Clevelander. That's always happening during the daytime. Part of it reminds me of Key West, Duval Street. You know, that's the kind of vibe you get at some of these bars and restaurants on Ocean Drive. Look, there's some tents out here. This just seems to be something going on here. Nothing's ringing. Maybe I should turn X or green on. Let's turn everything on and see what we get. I'm just... The mass of people here, I just can't believe that nothing's coming in. Oh, look, where Tony Montana chainsawed that guy in the bathroom. Chainsaw scene. It's a CBS. Alright, I got a Comfort Electric here on 6th and Ocean. Not sure where the guy is. But it's going into downtown.
Question mark. I'm sorry.
I parked over here and I sent him a message. So we'll see each other in downtown or Coconut Grove area. Not bad. Comfort Electric is hidden today.
I got told 6th and Ocean. He's, now the customer texted me, he was a block away. He's walking to me. You know what? Driving around right now would be a pain in the ass.
All right. A $17.44 Comfort Electric. And it was a nice couple. I think they're going to tip. Comfort Electric's been tipping. I'm at the Mayfair House. This is this classic hotel here in the Grove. I've actually done a DoorDash vlog where I had a delivery here. They've remodeled it and made it look nice. And it's beautiful on the inside. I show it in that DoorDash vlog. That's one thing about DoorDash, huh? You actually go into these places. You don't just hover on the outside. But, man, that wasn't a bad little trip, man. Grove to the beach. I wish I could do this all day. I think I'm gonna get something to eat here that I'm by the Grove, and then pick up a little bit later. So, I'm signing off for now. I'll catch you guys a little later. Ah! So I just got a call from Uber. I usually check back there, but since it was black, last guy I dropped off at the Mayfair left his phone. So Uber called me. I was like, yeah, if you're on the line with him, just tell him I'll come right back. I know the hotel. But the way they do it is they share your private number with them. Now he's going to call me, and I'm like, I mean, is he on the phone with you? Like, just tell him I'm on my way back. But they don't do it that way. So the guy's going to call me, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to tell you, I'm downstairs. I didn't go far, but whatever. And I'm going to get a $20 fee. So, hey, not only was it a good Comfort Electric ride, it turned into a premiere with the $20 finder's fee. So, hey, good luck. And good thing that I didn't accept another ride while I left.
Hello.
Hi, this is the Uber driver.
Hi, yes. Thank you much.
This is for Jonathan, right? I have your phone.
Yes,
I didn't see it because it's black and it was against the seat, so.
Obviously, he didn't see it either for the same reason.
No problem. I'm in the area, so if you meet me downstairs, I'll just bring it back to you.
Okay. About 5 or 10 minutes.
Okay. When will you be there?
Like 5 or 10 minutes.
Okay, no problem. That's fine. I'll be downstairs. I'm nearby. I didn't go far.
Okay, awesome. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you. All right, I dropped off that guy's phone and bam, handed me a 20 spot. I mean, I guess it's really chump change when you consider you could have not had your phone the rest of your vacation. Which is always a bummer, man. Man, losing your phone is the worst. It's almost like the worst. It's funny how, you know, not that long ago, nobody had, oh my God, and he just tipped me 15 through the app. Oh my God. This is like a $75 ride to the Grove, just out of happenstance. That's crazy. I was just gonna say how, like, it wasn't that long ago where nobody even thought about having a smartphone, and now losing one is probably the worst thing that could happen to you ever. All right, just finish scarfing down some Burger King. I gotta say,
There's something about McDonald's nuggets that these other companies just can't touch, huh? The nuggets at Burger King, even the nuggets at Wendy's. There's something to be said about the magic formula McDonald's has with their chicken McNuggets. They can't be, is it that hard to reverse engineer how good those are? Or just the consistency of them? Anyhow, and the sauces are better at McDonald's, bar none. Bar none. I gotta say though, the Spideyverse Whopper, two thumbs up. Number 10, 10 out of 10. They killed it with the fucking Spider-Verse. It's the third time I've had it.
I didn't vlog it, did I? Oh no, I put it on my Instagram. That's where I was talking to Austin. And I also put it on my B-Reel, because B-Reel pops up at random times of the day and you have to like take the photo then, whatever you're doing. And I was at Burger King. Here's the B-Reel. But,
and I needed to use the bathroom, now I'm refreshed. Might even go to the car wash, man. I think I want to vacuum this a little bit before the car wash closes. It's still, it's only 2:30. Man, dude, it's 2:30. If they give me those $20 for the late thing, I'm at $95 right now. You see what a difference starting the day early is when there's no traffic? This is what I was bitching about the other day. How you run some errands before you start and you could be losing, you know, $50 right off the bat. You're down 50. So it just takes a lot of planning to make money off this Uber app. So I'm ready to log back in, but I think I'm going to go to the car wash. And this vlog is way too long. Like, I don't know. Maybe I should just do my things, do a few rides, and give an update later on. Otherwise, this is going to be another 2-hour vlog, and no one's going to watch that. So, all right, I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, was home, took a nap, did a little Comfort Electric from the airport. It was a Uber Green. But it is 7:30, I'm rested. I saved some drive time, and let's hit it again.
All right, I'm still a little drowsy, but Key Biscayne Boat Show, let's hit it. I've turned everything on except X and green. It's showing a little surge in Key Biscayne. I think it's a good thing to scope it out. Now, the other thing. Yeah, it's good to refresh the algorithm. It's like, you know, now Uber thought for a couple hours, Mario might be done. He made enough money. Maybe he doesn't need any money. Boom. I'm activated again. You know, because things were slowing down a bit, but, and who knows how things are going to be tonight. So you want to save some of those drive hours. What if I get some reservations in the morning? You know? So anyways, let's see. Oh, yeah, I forgot to mention, somebody on the group chat got a premiere hourly this afternoon. It's insane. He closed it out, and it was something like $2.25 or something. So everybody's congratulating him, because that's like the rarest thing that you can get, is a premiere hourly pops up, and you almost can't believe it. It's only happened to me once, and I didn't vlog it. I might have talked about it, but I didn't vlog it. I pray for one of those. All right, we are headed to Key Biscayne. There's already surges, 750 surge popping up. Now it's gone. I've
I'm starting to like unassign myself, because see, right now, while I'm about to make the right turn into the Rickenbacker Causeway, what if they give me a shitty little fucking ride in Brickell or something? I don't want them to fuck with me. I want to turn on when I'm in the island already, on the causeway. That's when I, see the Rusty Pelican, I'll turn this fucker on. All right, almost at the peak of the bridge. Haven't turned on yet. As soon as I see that Rusty Pelican. And there it is, to the left, Rusty Pelican. Logged in. 525 surge, it says. All right, let's go, come on. There's also just people in Key Biscayne that want to go out on a Saturday night. Nothing to do with this damn boat show. Oh yes, it's about to get dark. I can just hear the nagging wives of these boat show goers. Oh, come on, honey, it's time to go. It's gonna get dark soon. I can hear that. Look at all these fuckers. Look at all these premier cars heading into the causeway. There's a clump of them just hanging out by the marina right there. Oh, there's a couple of them in Rusty Pelican. They're probably parked there.
All right. We are in the residential neighborhood.
Of course, now all the surges are gone, but I got a 350. But it said 450 or something, or 475 a minute ago. But as soon as I approached and I started climbing up the surge ladder, now it's gone. So, fuckers. Going, driving to Key Biscayne is always a risk. And you know what? After this weekend, I might take a little break from Key Biscayne. It's just a big risk, man. You waste time. You can do other rides some other places. And when you leave out of here, sometimes you don't always leave with Premier. You leave with a Comfort that sucks, or even worse, an X.
All right, going through the maze of residential streets here. The biggest come up right now would be a Premier ride to the airport.
Boy, if I get a Premier ride from here to the airport, not only is it big money, but you just keep Premier on and you hope for a Premier ride out of the airport. It's the Uber ride of my dreams. Nothing yet. I might fucking turn Comfort on real quick. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and turn other things on because Premier's not jumping. And you know what? I need to get the fuck out of here. Let's turn green on. Let's do everything except X. Maybe we'll get a Comfort. It's more likely. Comforts leave here all the time.
All right, I've been too long with everything except X off. I think I'm just going to get out of here.
I have a feeling that the residents of Key Biscayne know that Uber drivers poach their area for upper-level rides. I can hear someone saying, "Oh, just Uber X. You'll get a great one," because if they get frustrated after a few hours of not getting a ride, and they'll accept a regular ride, and you'll get the premium vehicle anyways. And they're right. But you know what? Not today. I'm not turning on X. I'll leave here with nothing before turning on X. Anyways, I'm gonna head out. If I get a ride, I could still be in the causeway and make a U-turn. Only time where you're fucked is when you cross the bridge from the Rusty Pelican over. Right there, you have to go all the way and turn into the fucking Brickell Avenue. It's a pain in the ass to come back. But before that, you can make a U-turn.
come on, honey, order the Premier Uber. I don't want to get in a stinky car anymore.
Honey, stinky cars don't hang around Key Biscayne. Only the Premier cars do.
All right, I am passing the event space for the boat show, but I am approaching the point of no return as far as Key Biscayne trips go. So if nothing comes in right now, I'm putting that little coffee cup and just trying my luck in Brickell. Going once, going twice, nothing. I cannot make a U-turn anymore. I am by the Rusty Pelican and approaching the fucking causeway. So I'm putting pause.
Fucking A, man. I've been burned so much in this goddamn Key Biscayne waiting for a fucking miracle. At least I get a little night view of the Brickell skyline. Alright, as soon as I left Key Biscayne, I'm on I-95. I got a Comfort Electric for $12+. Courtyard. Is that a Marriott? Comfort Electric and Marriott, man. That guy gave me a big fucking clue. Maybe I should need to hang around Marriott hotels with Comfort Electric on. Seems to be some sort of deal going on. So, alright, cool. Short ride. It's only going to take me like 15 minutes. So, I'm happy. Key Biscayne, fail. Never again. Well, maybe again, but not for anytime soon.
Oh, that traffic looks great. Alright, whoa, that looks bad. Good thing we're not going on that line. Alright, Brickell, here we go.
Dropped off those people at the restaurant here on Brickell. Wow, that was an expensive Comfort Electric for what it was, the distance. I mean, I did have a 350 surge, but I'm going to turn Comfort on and green. Fuck it. I'm turning everything except X on. I just need to do rides, man. Anyways, I'm at 34% after 11. The charger at West Avenue is 13 cents. So I'll go there. Chargers at Brickell are still expensive.
All right, I fucking turned on Uber X, man. I mean, we're in goddamn Brickell, right? I mean, shit. I just get so frustrated waiting for these other categories to hit. If they're not hitting, I need to start moving and shaking, bro.
I can't wait around, man. I just, there's limited drive time too. It's like every fucking 30 minutes to an hour that I don't have a fucking order. So anyways, I accepted this $8 fucking X ride, and you won't believe where the fucking guy lives. Like, some of the most wealthy real estate in Brickell. It's this fucking island called Brickell Key. It's right off 8th Street and Brickell Avenue. It's an own island. Check it out. All right, and he's going a little bit to 37th Avenue, kind of near the airport. My first thought was, cleaning lady? Uber cleaning lady ride? Hey, you know, you rich fucks, give your cleaning lady at least a Comfort, you fucking cheap bastards. She just finished wiping the fucking piss and shit out of your toilets. How about a Comfort ride? Give her some fucking leg room. Jesus. Pisses me off, bro.
Here we go. We gotta take a little bridge over to the private island. All for an X ride. And the traffic leaving this little island doesn't look great either.
All right, I am here at Magic City Casino. As you can see, nice elderly couple. You know, they probably got money. Who knows? They're probably gonna tip me like crazy. Gave them a pleasant ride. Gave them the premium experience. Temperature okay, everything. Boom, Comfort Electric. Hitting again. I just turned I just turned Uber X off for the ride over here. You know what? I'm just going to turn it... If I don't get Comfort Electrics or Comfort... I'm going to turn Uber X on and just run the rest of the fucking night. All right? I'm not going to vlog every fucking thing. It's 9:45 p.m. I don't plan on working late night, unless I get some crazy reservations. But I'm just going to plow through. And I'll come back to you. It's 9:45. When will I come back to you? And I'll give you an update of everything I did. Because this vlog is way too fucking long, bro. And I still got tomorrow. I'm going to vlog tomorrow, bro. I got breakfast with my family. First breakfast since my parents left for that cruise. So I got breakfast. And then I'm going to hit the ground running. So I don't want to be too tired tonight. All right. I'll see you. Maybe I should do the diamond thing I used to do with DoorDash. Diamond transition.
Update.
It's 11. I've pretty much stayed in Brickell. Comfort Electric, bro. Hitting. All to the Marriott's. Marriott, Comfort Electric. It's the way to go. Fucking downtown bridge got me waiting for like 20 minutes. I just drove these beautiful women to this East Miami building. All right, Uber Green, 1266, taking me out of the area. You know what? Fuck it. I want to get the fuck out of here. Of course I'm in the wrong fucking lane. Gotta go that way. I'm here at Dadeland Station. Charging a little bit. I'm watching Father Stew. I can't watch anything full. I can't watch anything like in one sitting anymore. It's so frustrating. But yeah, I'm here and I don't have to charge all the way, so I'm probably going to head out. And I only got 3 hours left of drive time, so I don't know. I'll just give a recap when I'm done. I might hit the Grove. I heard there's some premieres at the Grove. Some premieres in Brickell. Down only. It's Willie texting me. Willie, this is when you're texting me. We're talking about the Heat. He's a Heat fan. He's telling me the Heat game tomorrow. Sunday night. Game 3 of the Heat versus Celtics. They're 0-2, so they've won the first two games of the series, but yet this fucking ESPN is saying they only have a 35% chance of winning. I just thought that was fucking, that's so retarded. So I was like, well, what if they win tomorrow night and then they're 0-3? Whatever, 3-0. Whatever, you know what I mean. What if they win 3-0? What are they going to be, 50-50 shot? The Celtics have a better chance of winning 4 games in a row than the Heat do winning just one more game. Like, what's it going to be? Anyways, I got a comfort ride immediately after charging at Fox's Lounge, my old stomping grounds from my mid-20s on. I used to go to Fox's all the time. It's right by my apartment. And, well, we're picking this chick up and we're taking her to Brickell. So, I'll see you there. Well, you never know where this thing is going to take you, bro. I'm in Fisher Island, not the ferry, but the actual island. I took the Tesla on the ferry. Vanderbilt Mansion. I guess Anderson Cooper's retirement home. Yeah, this is like next level shit. Premier ride. I was looking for that stupid Bitcoin party on Watson Island by Parrot Jungle because there was supposed to be some party there. So I'm driving around just to check it out, drive by Parrot Jungle. And I get a premiere ride for $12.
going to the Fisher Island Ferry. I'm like, okay, cool. That's an easy Premier ride. But it's like, I usually drop people off there. And then they get in their cars or they take the ferry. This dude had me take the Tesla on the ferry and come over here. This is insane. If you thought Key Biscayne was wealthy, check this out. It's like a fucking castles. Jesus. I mean, it's no secret Fisher Island is like, you know, for millionaires and billionaires. Probably more billionaires than millionaires, to be honest with you. Now I'm gonna take the ferry back. But it's so weird. I'm gonna end the vlog with the ferry ride. Cause it's just so unique. It feels like you're on a cruise. You're just in the middle of the port of Miami in a car. Yeah. I don't even want to know the guy's net worth that I drove here and his wife. I got a pretty good idea who it was, but I'm not going to say, you know, to keep privacy. But yeah, probably in the billions. So, leave a like, comment, and subscribe with a B. Or, if you think I'm sus, and I definitely am, then subscribe. Always tip your Uber driver, always tip your food delivery guy. Because one day, even if you live on Fisher Island, motherfucker, that motherfucker might be me. All right, signing off. I'll leave you with what it feels like to leave Fisher Island by car and ferry.
So now a guy came up to my car, looked at my tag and said, I can't find your tag anywhere. And I said, I'm an Uber driver. I just dropped somebody off. And he's like, oh, okay. Now he's there talking to another guy in a golf cart, like security. Now the ferry just pulled up.
Let's see if I can film this without them thinking I'm filming. See the ferry there?
All right, now I'm going on this ramp to the ferry. I'm trying to film without them knowing.
Ferry has markers 1, 2, and 3. You go all the way.
And the guy comes up and he tells me I gotta turn off my lights. I don't know why, but I guess it makes sense. I gotta be honest with you that just being on this ferry and it rocking is like giving me like a little bit of seasickness. Especially, you know, I see now I'm looking at this cargo ship in front of me and I feel, am I moving or is the cargo ship moving?
If this wasn't a Premier, this wait time to get on and wait time to get off is not worth it. And it goes back to my previous assumptions of living on one of these private islands is it must suck. It must really suck. You have to have everything you need on that fucking island. Because good luck getting a Slurpee. Unless there's a 7-Eleven on Fisher Island. Late night McDonald's craze. Crave. You could tell it's late. I'm fucking delirious. You go wait through this shit to get some fucking nuggets? Not me. It's like, yeah, fuck. Being a billionaire is fucking annoying.
All right, I think we're gonna move soon. I had to wait for a whole shipping container to move before we took off.
I got an hour and 47 minutes of drive time left.
Wynwood's got a $19 surge. Could it be I was wrong about the Bitcoin bros?
I don't think so. Because if they were offering up money, there wouldn't be surges there. This is so cool, bro. I'm in the port of Miami. See the port, next port to my left. Downtown to the center. The MacArthur Causeway to the right. All right. I'll give a recap of what I did tonight in tomorrow's video. Good night, everyone.